My name is John Moran and I work for the Alaska Fisheries Science Center in Juneau, Alaska. And I work with humpback whales and herring. I'm looking at predation effects of humpback whales on some local herring populations in the Gulf of Alaska. I do a lot of winter field work in the Gulf of Alaska. Prince William Sound, Sitka Sound, and Lynn Canal. My day-to-day routine involves photo ID, biopsy, collecting prey, and sampling prey with different nets and fishing lines, point and toes, trying to figure out what humpbacks are eating and how much of the prey that they are eating.
Here he goes. Got him. That's smudge.
So we use photography to identify individual whales. It gives us an idea of that they're whales' abundance. Humpback whale flukes are uniquely marked. The markings identify an individual, and we can actually follow individuals, see if they have prey preferences, location preferences, and then it all fits into a formula and figure out how many whales are actually around. Our research is happening because of the success of the Marine Mammal Protection Act. Humpback whales have had a remarkable recovery. Humpback whale numbers are going up 5 to 7% a year, and we're looking at potential conflicts with fisheries, with the herring population, with other forage fish populations, and we want to know what the ecological impact is of all these humpbacks. So it looks like in Sitka Sound, the whales aren't really having an effect. They're probably taking less than 1% of the herring. In Lynn Canal, we're not sure what's happening here. They could be having an effect depending on what the herring population structure is. And in Prince William Sound, it looks like they're eating about 15 to 20% of the herring biomass in the wintertime. So that's about the equivalent of the commercial fishery that used to happen there. So they've basically replaced the commercial fishery. So what we're having is a lot more conflicts with marine mammals now. Now we're having entanglements of humpback whales in commercial fishing gear and sport fishing gear. There's conflicts between Stellar sea lions and fishing gear. We're having conflicts between sperm whales and longliners off the coast. So this new regime with lots of marine mammals, it's forcing us to adapt and relook at some other issues and come up with some solutions that'll hopefully benefit the fishermen and the marine mammals. We'll be right back.